Hey, Rich, it's you, Money Maniacs. Welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about the definition of true wealth. What does that actually mean? Let's get right to it. Hey, Rich, it's you, Money Maniacs. Welcome back. I'm Tom. Thanks for tuning in again. In this video, I want to talk about the definition of true wealth. Everybody has their own version of wealth and what it really means to them, and that's exactly what I'm going to share with you. Mine's a little bit different though. True wealth to me is something that has to be quantifiable. That's the first element of true wealth. It's something that you can measure. A lot of folks will say, well, I'm wealthy because I have this, or I'm very happy, or I'm very spiritual, or I have a big family and so I'm wealthy. And actually, the big family example is a good example because you can measure how many family members you have and how well you get along. Do you get along with your family? So that's something that's actually measurable. The other things, though, your happiness or your spirituality or more ephemeral things, those are not measurable. Be very discerning when accepting something like that into your definition of wealth. It is important to be happy. It is important to be spiritual, but you cannot measure them. So keep that in mind when you're talking about expanding your wealth or becoming wealthy. There's a very big difference. The first is quantifiable. So make sure that whatever you include in your definition of true wealth, it's able to be measured. How many family members and how well do we get along? You can always tell how well you get along with other people by how you treat each other when you see them and how often you get to see them. So that's pretty easy. Do they bring you joy or do they bring you anxiety? There you go. That's another good measure. When you see this person from your family, do you feel relief and joy and they help lift you up? Or do they bring you down and tell you, you know, how terrible you are, you're no good and you'll never amount to anything? There's a good measure. The other thing that's quantifiable but is absolutely vital when it comes to describing or defining wealth is finance. Money, the true value exchange. And I'm not even talking about currency. If you're unsure about what the difference between money and currency is, make sure you check out the video I did that explains the very distinct difference between money, value exchange, and currency, which is the fake stuff that you carry around in your wallet, or even the ones and zeros that you have in your apps. So, quantifiable amounts of value exchange, quantifiable amounts of money, quantifiable amounts even of currency in your bank account, money that you have access to, but more important, money that you're able to generate whenever you need it. So you don't have to be super rich to be wealthy. If you have the skill to generate large amounts of money or large amounts of currency at the drop of a hat, whenever you need it. Oh, my neighbor can't pay their gas bill, their winter gas bill. Or, my family needs an operation and it's gonna cost $1 million. If you have the ability to generate that in a very short period of time because you just know money so well and you know business so well, then you're wealthy. The ability to generate value, the ability to generate revenue streams, the ability to generate large sums of money whenever you need it, at the drop of a hat, at your whim, whenever you just want, oh, you know what, I like that car, I'm gonna buy that car. That's wealth. That's true wealth, which actually leads to the next part of my definition of true wealth, and that is freedom. Do you have enough financial power to be able to tell somebody who thinks they're your superior, no, I'm not going to do what you say, and you can't make me. In fact, I don't need to deal with you at all. I make all of the rules in my own life. Now see, that's the real golden rule. And you can look around at the governments around the world too and see the same thing. The golden rule is, he who has the gold makes the rules. This is why you need to study finance and you need to understand money intimately so that you have the power to really be free. When the lockdown occurred and everybody was scared of the health challenge that was out, you know what a lot of wealthy people did? They booked private flights and used their second passports to go to other countries where they felt safe, where they were appreciated, where they were not being taxed. See, that's a whole nother video that I'm gonna do for you guys. This fellow that I've started watching, the Nomad Capitalist, he says it best. Go where you're treated the best. Once you understand money, you'll understand why that's so important. Because in the United States, in the Western world, it has become exceedingly difficult to open a business, to generate a profit, and to be able to store that value for yourself, because you've got bureaucrats and lobbyists and a Federal Reserve central banking system constantly stealing that value from you through inflation, through currency creation, through taxation without representation. They sneak around every corner, every chance they get. And so it becomes more and more difficult for you, the person who's actually working to generate the value, to be able to keep the value. Now remember something, when you're the one generating the value and it helps somebody else and not you, that's called slavery. And that's another video that I've already done. We talked about socialism and how it rides on the back of capitalism. That is a very perfect and pure example of it. When you generate value, but you don't get to enjoy that value and someone else does, whether it's a bureaucrat, whether it's a homeless person, whether it's anybody other than you, that is called slavery. Keep that in mind, because freedom is absolutely essential to real, true wealth. So let's go back now. What were the three elements that are so important? Quantifiable, it must be measurable. Even your health is measurable. You can get blood tests and have your blood measured. Your health is vital too, and it can be measured. So it's got to be quantifiable. You must be able to generate large amounts of money whenever you need it. So you could either start a business or own a business or own streams of revenue or just be smart enough to be able to take advantage of an opportunity. You see a piece of real estate, you buy it cheap and you develop it and sell it for lots of money and take that profit and help your family get that operation. Things like that. The third one is freedom. If you don't have the freedom to move about the world whenever you want, and have the resources and money to be able to do it, to be able to book that private jet, to be able to book that nice hotel or have a property that you own in another country. If you don't have the money in the bank, currency in the bank, if you don't have gold or silver to back up as backups, if you don't have an emergency fund, then you do not have freedom, because he who has the gold makes the rules. So there you go. My personal definition of true wealth involves those three very important elements. It's not just about winning the lottery and having some currency. It's about all three of those things being combined to provide you with true wealth and true freedom. I hope this was helpful. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And even better, if you like what I'm talking about, subscribe to the channel and definitely stick around for more information that hopefully will help you achieve your true wealth and your true freedom too. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you again real soon.